In a previous video, we created a K3s cluster with a set of Raspberry Pis. So that's great, we have a cluster now, but now we need to do something with it. And we actually need to do a little more setup with it to make it truly useful, but there are some things that we can do, so let's go ahead and learn how to do that now. In this video, we will deploy an Nginx website, and we'll make use of some of the traffic routing we talked about in the previous video. Requirements for this video, all you need is your running K3s cluster we created last time. In the previous video, we did just a little simple deploy directly from the kubectl command line. The more typical way to create a deployment is to use YAML configuration files. That's what we'll do in this video. We'll kind of start at the top and work our way down. We want to start with the deployment configuration. And typically the way that I get these configuration files is I just go to kubernetes.io, look in their docs, and then find the configuration file I want. In this case, I'll look at deployment. We will scroll down until you see the sample. We'll just copy that out and then stick it in a file of our own. And I'll just call this file mysite.yaml for this application. We just paste in the file and we'll go and edit a few things to make it more custom for us. So I'll call this mysite.nginx, and then the app label I'll make the same. I just want one replica here because we just really want one pod for this sample. I call it mysite.nginx. This will also be mysite.nginx. The name of the container can just be nginx. And we're going to use the Nginx image from Docker Hub, and I want to use the latest, so I'll drop the version here. The container port is actually correct. We want to use port 80 here. This is the deployment configuration. It will actually go download Nginx from Docker Hub, and it will create a pod that runs Nginx on port 80 inside the cluster. Next, we'll make a service configuration, and we can put this in the same file. We just separate it with these three dashes. A service in Kubernetes is kind of an abstraction for your pods. The service is where you will give your service a name, and you'll give it a target port, like port 80 for a website, and it'll actually has the ability to load balance against any number of running pods for your service. So we'll create the service configuration the same way. We'll go find the template, copy it out, and paste it into our file, and then update it to what we want. We'll call this mysite nginx service. So this is where the service matches the backend pods. We called our app mysite nginx, so we need to select that app for the service here. Protocol is TCP, and we'll be using port 80. That's it for the service configuration. Put in three more dashes and move on to the next configuration. The next configuration is the ingress configuration. This is the configuration that traefik will use to actually get traefik from the outside of your cluster to the service that you want and onto the pods that actually handle the requests. So we'll do the same deal. We'll go get the ingress resource. We're actually going to have to change this one a little bit because traefik is a little bit different than the default boilerplate. Let's do our naming changes. We'll call this mysite nginx ingress. The rules are pretty much the same. We're going to stick this right on the root for the path, so we'll just use slash. The service name now has to match the service that we defined above, so we'll call it mysite nginx service. Service port is port 80, so we're happy with that. I'm going to dump this annotation and add the annotation for traefik. This is kubernetes.io/ingress.class, and the class is traefik. This is just an annotation that says, hey, use traefik for this ingress rule. We'll save that. That actually completes our configuration. Not too bad. Now we need something to actually deploy. I've created a simple sample HTML file for our website that I'll link to in the video description. We kind of need a place to store it. Now, we haven't really talked about storage mechanisms in Kubernetes yet, so we're going to cheat a little here and just poke this into a config map. This This is not the recommended way to do this, not the recommended way to deploy a website. But until we get to the better ways, we'll use it for now. Okay, to do that, we can just do kubectl create config map. We'll give it a name, mysite-html. We'll say load this from the file index.html. That command actually took our index.html file and stuck it into this special Kubernetes resource called a config map. It's just basically a way of storing a file or a set of files inside Kubernetes. Now we need a way to tell our pod where that file is and how to use it. We do that with Kubernetes volumes. So we'll go into our config file. We'll tell our container that it has a volume with the volumes tag. We'll give it a name of HTML volume. We'll say it's a config map, and the config map's name is mysite-html. That's the name we used in the previous step when we created the config map. That will get the volume into the container, but it's still not mounted anywhere. To do that, we need to put in the key volume mounts. We'll give it a name. We want to mount the HTML volume. We want to mount it at a mount path of /share/nginx/html. Why there? That's the path in the default Nginx image where the HTML files live. So those sample files that are in that image, we're going to actually overlay that path with our own volume, and it's going to have the contents of that we stuck in that config map. So the container has a volume, HTML volume. HTML volume has the HTML from our little sample site in it, and we're going to mount that at /user/share/nginx/html, and then Nginx will actually serve those files. Okay, with that specified, we can save the file. And now we just need to deploy it. We could do that with a simple kubectl apply-f mysite.yaml. You can see from the output that it created a deployment, it created the service, and it created the ingress record. Now if we run kubectl get pods, you can see it still has a status of container creating. That means it's still trying to create our container to bring up our pod. Typically the first time, it'll take some time because remember, for this pod, it has to go out and download the Nginx image from Docker Hub, and that may take some time. We'll run kubectl get pods again, and hey, now we see it's running. Now we're ready to try it out. But before we do that, let's look again at the configuration and see exactly how this is going to work. Since we created an ingress record with traefik, when traefik receives HTTP traefik for a path matching slash or anything below that, it's going to send it to the service, mysite nginx service on port 80. So that goes to the service record. The service says, when I receive traefik on port 80, I'm going to send it to the app, mysite-nginx. Mysite Nginx is a single pod. It's running the Nginx image, running on port 80, and it's serving up our custom HTML from our config map. That's the theory. Let's see if that works. We open up a new tab on our browser. We can just go to KMaster, and there's our site. Well, that wasn't too bad. But now we have this whole K3s cluster that's serving a single website. What if I have two sites? This is where we start to see the power of traefik being able to direct traefik to different services. To look at this deeper, we need to create something else to deploy. It just so happens that my dog has a message that she really wants the world to know. So I've pre-created a website just for her. I'll link those files in the video description for you to follow along. So the first step, we'll cheat and poke this in a config map like we did before. I'll do a kubectl create config map, call it mydog-html. We'll do --from file HTML. In this case, this is an HTML folder, and it's going to pull in more than one file. That's okay, it works the same. So now we need to create the YAML configuration like we did before. Since it's going to be close to what we did before, we'll just copy the mysite.yaml to mydog.yaml. We'll go in and change the pieces that we need. So first, we will just search for my site and replace it with my dog. That'll take care of most of the boilerplate. We'll go through this line by line. Most everything is the same here. We're still using the volumes. We have a different name for our volume, mydog-html, so we'll change that. The service is the same. Looks good. In the ingress, we'll make some changes here. Now we want to serve on the path my dog. This will direct traffic for the path my dog to the my dog Nginx service, whereas all the other paths will still be directed to my site Nginx service. You can see this is where traffic is starting to make decisions about where incoming traffic goes. There's one little gotcha here. My HTML doesn't actually have the my dog prefix. So there's an annotation that we can send the traffic to strip off this my dog prefix. Let's do that here. The annotation is traffic dot frontend dot rules dot type, and we'll say path prefix strip. Since we're using path-based ingress configuration, traffic will make a decision based on the path of which service to send our incoming request to. So now let's give this a shot. We'll deploy this like we did before. We'll say kubectl apply dash f mydog.yaml. You can see the three pieces again were created. We give it a little bit of time. And we'll do a kubectl get pods. We can see that my dog Nginx is now running. So let's try it out. Just refresh this, make sure that that still works. Now we're going to go to kmaster my dog. And now my dog's message is out to the world. We can all get some sleep tonight. Okay, so now we can actually do something with our k3s cluster. We're doing just standard websites here. Everything these days is TLS and SSL. In the next video, we're going to install CERT Manager so we can do it TLS and SSL as well. Before we wrap up this video, since what we just created were kind of samples, maybe you don't want them hanging around on your cluster, you want to get rid of them, I want to show you how to do that. You can reverse most of what we did by just doing a kubectl delete -f mydog.yaml. That'll clean up all the Kubernetes pods. And we created the config map manually, so we need to clean that up manually. So we'll do kubectl delete config map mydog-html. We'll do the same steps for my site to get rid of the original site. We'll also delete the config map for my site HTML. And then we will do a kubectl delete -f mysite.yaml to get rid of the other pieces. Do a kubectl get pods, and everything is clear. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more, please consider subscribing to my channel.